Scott Folks. Thanks for being with us on this Thursday edition of Game On. Happy to have you here. Hope you've had a great week. Tomorrow, the last day of it. Aren't we all just working for the weekend? This is your nightly dose of sports talk on North Georgia's News Talk. I'm Katie B. Davis. This portion of the show brought to you by Nichols Body Shop. From dents and dings to major collision damage, Nichols Body Shop, the place to go, folks. They can do it all, and Nick and Laura will, per repair, donate $25 to your high school organization of choice. They're big high school sports supporters, big high school supporters in our listening area, not just Hall County, and big supporters of Game On, and we sure do appreciate them. Nichols Body Shop, located on Atlanta Highway in Flowery Branch. Go see Nick and his men for all of your car repair needs. The Georgia gymnastics team is a pillar of excellence, a traditional powerhouse, and starting tomorrow, the Gym Dogs are competing in the NCAAs for the 30th time. I was able to catch up with Coach Dana Durante earlier today, post-final practice ahead of tomorrow's meet, and I asked initially what the process has been like to get her squad to this year's NCAAs.
It's certainly been a long season. We've had some moments of brilliance and some moments where we kind of went, uh-oh, what happened? But I think that is not all that uncommon, particularly when you have some new faces in the lineup and lots of young faces. And so over the course of the year, they've certainly learned to compete with confidence and learn to compete as a team. No question, we struggled a bit at regionals, but I think a big reason why that happened is this team just wants so badly to excel on such a high level, and so sometimes I think your mind can get a little ahead of your body, and so we worked on that the last couple of weeks. But it's been exciting to watch them grow, not only as athletes but also as individuals. We take great pride and a great obligation we feel that we have in just growing them as young people. So it's been a fun journey up to this point.
You mentioned those fresh faces, and you have had some freshmen come in this season and do extremely well for you. What are your plans on using the freshmen in the NCAAs?
We'll have roughly the same lineup that we had at regionals, with the exception of Ashlyn Broussard, another freshman, will be back in the floor lineup, and she's trained extremely well over the last several months, really, and so we're excited to see her back out there on floor. But we have a great number of our routines performed by freshmen and sophomores, really. So, like I said, the freshmen have learned, and in those struggles early on, they've learned from them. They've learned how to compete better, certainly on a stage like this. We felt ourselves at practice today having to issue reminders and, slow down, take your time, those types of things. But, there's a significant number of performances we're going to be counting on freshmen for those tomorrow and again on Saturday.
Obviously important in gymnastics that your young ladies stay on an even keel, and you just mentioned having to calm them down a bit in practice today. Do you think the excitement of the moment is going to overwhelm them a little bit? And what's your plans to calm them down come meet time tomorrow?
That's a good question. And I would love for the excitement sort of fill them up. This group tends to or has shown signs of just getting intense and tight and almost thinking too much. So we've talked about just enjoying it. So I would love for them to be enjoying the excitement and the thrill of everything that goes along with getting to this point, and knowing that all of their work up until this point has been worth it, and the reward is right here at the end of the road, and let that excitement really fill them up, as opposed to thinking of it in terms of something that's not positive, in terms of pressure or anything like that. I want them to view it as excitement and joy and opportunity. And so we did have to give some of those reminders today. I'm certain we'll have to do some of those again tomorrow. So that takes just a watchful eye from us as a staff, and a good calm tone saying, hey, we got it, let's go, let's just take care of business. So we'll certainly be ready for that. But I know that they're excited to be there, and I really just want them to enjoy it all, because when we talked about that again today, when we're relaxed and we're having a good time, we all perform at our best. So that's going to be our goal for tomorrow.
We mentioned in specific your freshman. I want to talk now, though, about a senior, and this one of local interest. Obviously, our home base is Gainesville, Georgia, and her mother went to East Hall High School, located in Hall County. And this is Lindsay Cheek, ninth on the balance beam, 16th on the vault. But, to use a pun, she has really catapulted herself onto the national scene this season. Talk a little bit about this young lady.
She really has. She came in last year and, when we came in last year, she had competed, mostly bowls, was a two-time All-American on that event, had done some bars, done a little bit, done some floor. So I know she had competed in the all-round a couple of times, but had been sidelined with some injury her sophomore year. And so we sat down right off the bat and just talked about you know, what it takes day in and day out at practice to be a great team player and to be confident going in. And she had talked about running down the vault runway, not sure what was going to happen on the other end of that vault because she hadn't trained enough and she never wanted to feel that again. And so we just talked about, you know, day in and day out numbers, just what that focus needed to look like. And I thought she did an amazing job last year. And she was determined this summer to take it a step further. And so she really was focused in her workouts this summer. You know, nutrition has been always an area of focus for Lindsay. She wanted to have better nutrition, and she really worked very hard on that this year, which just makes your body last longer, gives you the fuel to do what you need to do every single day. And so, you know, that coupled with her work ethic, I think, over the last several months has really just allowed her to go out and compete to her potential every meet. And so it's been really fun to watch her grow and watch her become a team leader. And, you know, just kind of say, all right, guys, we got it. Let's go. I really enjoy watching her, you know, in her role as a team leader and as a senior, and knowing that she's worked so incredibly hard to get where she is. It's very rewarding, I know, for her and for us at the South and for her family.
And in addition to being ninth on the beam, 16th on the vault, the young lady's ranked second nationally on bars, so having herself a whale of a season. You all have struggled a bit this season in floor routine, struggled a bit this season on the balance beam. How have those struggles rectified themselves in time for the NCAAs?
You know, I certainly think that a large part of that struggle was us messing with those lineups so much over the course of the season. And, you know, each circumstance was different why we changed that lineup. But, you know, that those lineups, like the bars and the vault lineup, have become their own little unit. And so every time we make a change in that, although it was necessary for us to make some of those changes, it throws that chemistry off of that event a little bit. And so we coming right out of regionals, set those lineups, and, you know, athletes knew where they were competing, when they were competing, who were they behind. I think it eased that stress a little bit. And we really have liked what we've seen over the course of the last few weeks on beam and floor. And I think, you know, they're incredible athletes on those events, and we've had to help them learn how to be incredible competitors. And they've shown moments of brilliance on those events, and I just think that's something we have to continue to work on as a staff, knowing that we need to continue to support them, encourage them, but also show that confidence in them that they're ready to go. So, it's been a bit of a process getting them to the right spot in those events, but I feel very strong about it and confident in what they're going to do tomorrow, and just really looking forward to seeing them perform.
We're wrapping up our conversation this evening with Dana Durante, Gym Dogs coach, looking for a second straight Super 6 bid, and will be competing tomorrow in the first semifinal session against Oklahoma, LSU, Michigan, Stanford, Illinois. Talk about tomorrow's competition as we wrap up, Coach. It's tough. It's a tough, whatever draw you get, it's going to be tough. But talk about tomorrow's competition in particular.
Yeah, it's a great field, no question. And I was speaking with another media person this morning just about the level of collegiate gymnastics has grown tremendously, which is very exciting for someone who, you know, came in as an athlete several years ago. I won't say how many, but several years ago, to watch the level of gymnastics just rise and rise and rise. And it's exciting to see our sport continue to grow and improve, and the level of difficulty across the board tomorrow. You know, all six teams in our session, the six teams in the evening session, yeah, they're tremendously talented. And so it's going to be a great competition. You know, we do our job. We do what we're capable of. We're in the Super 6. We need to come in and compete free, like I said, and compete relaxed and at ease and just take it one skill, one event at a time. And when we do that, we will be competing on Saturday. So that's our goal. That's our focus. And it's going to be an exciting meet, both the afternoon session and the evening session.
Wanting the tradition of the Gym Dogs' dominance in the NCAAs nationally to continue, I think they got the right woman in you, Dana Durante, and I appreciate you being with us tonight. Best of luck to you all this weekend, and hopefully we can talk to you again soon. We appreciate your time.
Sounds great. Thank you so much for having me. Go Dogs.
I loved it that she wrapped up the interview with Go Dogs. Any Bulldog coach you ever interview will. All of you out there listening who interview Georgia Bulldogs coaches as often as I do will end it by saying Go Dogs. Now, Georgia Tech coaches don't end interviews by saying Buzz or Go Tech or whatever their catchphrase is. But most Georgia Bulldog coaches end by saying Go Dogs. Yes, Brian?
I mean, it'd be smart for the athletic director to make that a part of their contract.
That they have to say Go Dogs.
Every media interview you ever have, you have to end that or throw that in there in some way, shape, or form.
You have to say Go Dogs at the end. In high school action today, folks, Flowery Branch boys, Gainesville girls won region 8-5A tennis titles. North Oconee girls won the region 8-3A track and field title. So congratulations to those teams. Any other updates we get in that area will bring forth over the course of the next 43 minutes as we continue this Thursday edition of Game On. I've never been to a gymnastics meet. I've got a dear friend who goes to them frequently. I'm not going to say a lot, but to me, frequently is like having been to two since the program began. But it's always been a point of pride for the University of Georgia, their gymnastics program. And obviously, Coach Euclid started it and had a great run with it, retired, I don't know, 5-6 years ago. They had somebody step in, and then Dana Durante came in, took the team to the Super Six last year, and hoping for that same type of success this year. But they're in the NCAAs for the 30th season. It's interesting, though, that's sort of the dominant sport, the continuous dominant sport at the University of Georgia, is the gymnastics team. And based on that, and having to keep up with that, the SEC schools that have begun gymnastics programs have all risen to that level. And so when you heard her talk about the level of competition as a whole being on the upswing, she's not kidding. There's more parity in women's gymnastics than there is in women's basketball. And you can say, oh, that's apples to oranges. It's not really. It's not really. There used to not be. All the best gymnasts went to Georgia. All the best gymnasts went to Florida. But now across the board, Oklahoma, really? There's parity. There's more parity in women's gymnastics than women's college basketball. Diamond DeShields' decision to transfer today, though, could throw a kink in that. And we talked about it yesterday, folks. We talked about it yesterday with Asia Jones going to South Carolina. Is that changing what women's basketball is? The decision by Diamond DeShields to transfer, and again, speculation, I think she's going to Georgia Tech, could follow suit. That could be changing women's basketball. And it, in my opinion, it would be for the better. 19 minutes after 7 o'clock, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, folks, we're going to continue your nightly dose of sports talk on North Georgia's News Talk. This is Game On. I'm Katie B. Davis. You're listening to WDUN.